Today we are going to discuss about the isolated ripening of cheese. We have already discussed various type of cheese, their manufacturing, their different processing parameter involved in their manufacture, their different type of defects, their causes and preventions. We have already discussed in some process of cheese how we can actually reduce the ripening period of cheese, particularly ripened hard variety of cheese. So today we are going to discuss about isolated ripening of cheese. You can understand that the name itself suggests that when we are increasing the rate of reaction or rate of ripening index, that leads to the different flavor development depending upon variety of cheese. So in this topic we are discussing what are the different methods and what are the different procedure by which we can actually enhance the ripening period of the cheese, particularly hard variety of cheese, very hard variety of cheese. Why we are go for isolated ripening of cheese? Because the number one reason of isolated ripening of cheese is that prolonged ripening of cheese are great economic concern to the cheese industry. Kyun? Kyunki it blocks the money invested, but also increases the cost of production due to application of refrigeration for maintaining the required temperature and humidity for curing of cheese. Another reason is that when we keep the cheese, there is certainly required for refrigeration temperature, and during refrigeration we need lots of energy, and this energy comes from the cost involved, also the cost of production of the cheese. This adds to the cost of production of the cheese also. Another one is that because industries require throughout demand of cheese, so to meet the demand, year round demand of the cheese, we are actually producing or reducing that ripening period of the cheese. So when we accelerate the ripening of cheese, definitely that reduce the cost of production, that also helps in reduction in the cost of storage also, and we can at the same time we can also meet the supply of the cheese in the market. So number one, there's two means. One is treatment with the cheese milk, and another one is treatment to the cheese curd. So here treatment of the cheese means either we can add increased level of starter culture or increased level of starter adjuncts. Another one may be modified starter means thermal soft cells. Modified cultures, starters also involve freeze soft cultures, lysozyme treated cells, muted cells, and also beta galactosidase. In addition to that, we can also add micro encapsulated ripening agents like liposomal enzymes and liposomal cell free extract. These are the the procedure by which we can treating the cheese milk. When we treating the cheese milk with the which we have mentioned here, then definitely they will accelerate the ripening of the cheese. Another treatment is that either we can also treat the cheese curd. The treatment given to cheese curd may involve protease enzymes, lipolyting enzymes, or enzyme cocktails. Anna, or you can also, when we add these different types of enzymes to the cheese, definitely the flavoring compounds, which mainly involves aldehyde, methyl ketones, and fatty acid, lactones, esters, amines, sulfur compounds, phenols, terpenes, alpha dicarbonyl, and related compounds. So these are the different compounds. They are actually responsible for the characteristic flavor of the cheese depending upon the ripening period involved in hard variety, when manufacture of hard variety of cheese. So we can also extend the ripening period. We have already discussed why accelerated ripening is required. So we can summarize here that number one, to reduce the cost of production or to reduce the great economic involved in the production of cheese. So we can extend ripening period due to considerable loss in weight and higher capital cost. Another one is to meet the demand of the cheese. And we can also, these are the additional purpose for accelerated ripening of cheese. Now comes into the process step by step. Number one is that after manufacture of cheese, that is green cheese, we have already teach you that there are two type of curing. One is hot curing, another one is cold curing. In the manufacture of cheddar cheese or even in Swiss cheese, we are actually recommending both type of condition, hot ripening and cold ripening. When we prefer hot ripening, definitely we can reduce the ripening period of the hard cheese. So here we can increase the level of temperature, that is the when we keep the cheese blocks at elevated temperature, that is 16 degree centigrade against the 8 degree centigrade, then we can reduce the maturation time, curing time more than 50%. So we can save 50% about energy when we keep the cheese blocks at elevated temperature. When we keep the cheese block at elevated temperature, there it has been observed that there is an increase in soluble nitrogen, free fatty acid, almost 90%. Here we can see the example Manchego cheese. When we ripen at 20 degree centigrade, we can get increased content of soluble nitrogen, free fatty acid profile, as compared to the cheese which are actually ripened at 5 degree centigrade. But this practice is very much popular because this required very strict hygienic condition during production and ripening. And also there may be chances of spoilage of the cheese when we not control the temperature strictly with strict hygienic condition. So there may be chances of loss of cheese, because when we prepare the cheese and there is not proper flavor, then definitely we can lose the cheese. Another one is that addition of one another is urgent culture. We have already tell you that in addition to the starter culture, we can also add adjunct culture. Adjunct culture means the culture which is supplemented along with the starter culture to further improvement in the flavor and further improvement in the flavor or body and texture in the cheese. So generally we can observe that the gen culture are non-starter lactic acid bacteria like L. helveticus, L. casei. So when we add L. casei, L. plantarum to the cheese mill, we can increase the level of microbial count in the range of 10 to power 5 to 10 to power 6 CFU per ml, which can help in attaining the highest flavor in the cheddar cheese. Similarly, when we add the starter culture along with Lactobacillus casei as a adjunct culture, they have positive influence on flavor, body and texture of buffalo milk cheddar cheese. I have already told you that when we prepare the cheddar cheese from the buffalo milk, there is a lack of production of flavoring compounds, because in buffalo milk, when you prepare the cheese from buffalo milk, their synthesis take place, and due to less moisture retention in the cheese block of buffalo milk, the rate of ripening, rate of reaction of ripening process is decreased, and which leads to not proper flavor compounds, which actually ultimately lack in flavor development. So to improve the flavor in the cheese particularly made from buffalo milk, we are actually supplemented the culture with the Lactobacillus casei, Lactobacillus helveticus, Lactobacillus plantarum to the cheese milk, so that we can get the almost same characteristic flavor as we observe in case of cow milk cheddar cheese. So we are actually recommending the addition of adjunct culture like L. helveticus, L. casei, L. plantarum, or hybrid of L. helveticus. They are actually definitely improve the flavoring compound as well as body and texture of the cheese. It has already been noticed in Iranian white cheese, that is, which includes also feta cheese, Italian cheese, that when we add Lactobacillus helveticus along to the starter culture, then they actually improve the sensory quality of the Iranian white cheese. So adjunct culture is another prominent method for enhancing the or accelerating the ripening of the cheese. So we can also opt for this one. Another one is that adjunct culture, then stimulation of starter cells. Stimulation of starter cells means that is some enzymes has been added to the starter cell for increase or hydrolyze, that means stimulate the growth of a starter cell, that is stimulated by addition of enzymes or hydrolyzed starter cell to the cheese. Ripening of Emmental type cheese, that is Swiss cheese, we can increase the, when we further increase the rate of production, rate of flavoring compound development in Swiss cheese by addition of protein hydrolytes and metalloproteinase, which is obtained from Micrococcus caseolaticus. So we can also improve the flavoring compound by stimulating the starter cells. How they can stimulate? Either we can add hydrolyzed protein hydrolytes, or we can add enzymes which can actually help in improving the or accelerating the flavor of the cheese. Now comes into the addition of modified starter culture. Modified starter culture means addition of modified starter culture or attenuated starter culture means increase in the content of starter cells without causing detrimental effect on the acidification schedule. The rate of production of acid development when we keep the cheese in the ripening room under controlled condition of temperature and humidity, the acidity development will not any hindrance acidity development during the ripening, which not affect that culture, will not affect the acidification schedule of the cheddar cheese or any hard cheese. So when we increase the number of starter cells, we can definitely improving the flavor of the cheese. All starter cells, automated starter cells, contribute to proteolysis and other changes which actually improve the sensory quality of the cheese. Or selection of starter strains with enhanced autolytic properties and increased peptide dyes activity definitely provide a more balanced flavor in the cheese. So we can also improve the flavor of the cheese by adding modified starter culture. So how we can modify? One is heat and freeze shock treated cells. Heat and freeze shock treated cells means when we use the L. helveticus, freeze shock L. helveticus, in case of cheddar cheese, we can actually reduce the ripening period to almost 50%. And we can actually reduce the ripening period up to 50%. That means we can save the energy up to 50%. So addition of heat shock or freeze shock culture are added to the cheese mill for improving or accelerating the ripening of the cheese. Similarly we can when we supplement the heat shock culture of S. thermophilus L. bulgarius, that leads to the development of natural flavor within 40 days in feta cheese. Generally feta cheese is getting flavor development required almost 90 days, but when we use heat shock culture like L. helveticus L. bulgaricus along with their native starter culture, they can reduce the development of flavor, or we can get the flavor within 40 days of ripening. Whereas when we prepare the cheese without any type of heat shock cultures to the cheese mill, then we can get the flavor at 90 days of ripening period. Similarly, in case of Gouda cheese, it has been observed that when we use freeze shock L. helveticus in case of buffalo milk Gouda cheese, they can also improve the flavor development in the Gouda cheese. So these are the ways by which we can actually increase the flavor or reduce the ripening period of the cheese. Similarly, mutant starter culture, and this also provides packet of informity, distributed proteinases or peptidases. वो क्या करता है कि during production है ना, they are actually increasing the level of free amino acid, increasing the level of peptides without interfering with the acid production, because acid production is required, because acid production or in the cheese manufacturing of cheese है ना क्या करता है, they retard the growth of proteolytic bacteria or putrefactive bacteria. So the culture is actually providing such type of atmosphere during ripening that they are not allow the growth of other type of bacteria, which actually leads to the creating defect or creating defect in the cheese. So we are using in such a way that the acid production